Welcome back to Beyond Words. I'm Mark Hart. This week, we talk about Luke chapter 13, and we're going to hear about the narrow gate. The narrow gate. You see, there are a lot of people in God's creation who think, who assume they're sitting pretty. They assume they're going to get into heaven. And then all of a sudden, Jesus comes and pulls up the e-brake on those assumptions and says, not so fast. What you have to understand is the path to heaven is narrow. The gate is not as wide as you think. You see, my brothers and my sisters, there's an HOV lane. There's a carpool lane to hell. But the lane to heaven is steep. It's jagged. It's narrow. It's hard. But it's not impossible. And they start to say, hey, will only a few be saved? And all of a sudden, we start to see people, they're asking questions in the gospel. They're almost wondering, who's on the VIP list? Who's the one who's going to see heaven, taste heaven? Lord, tell us. We're reminded again, those famous words, the beautiful gospel paradox, the last shall be first, and the first shall be last. Ponder that for a second. How many people on their deathbed have absolute certainty that they're going to heaven? How many people on their deathbed know without a shadow of a doubt where they're destined for? Some say many, some say few. Now back it up 20 years. Back it up to your life right now or 20 years ago. Where do you sit with God? Are you one of the first or one of the last in earthly terms? Because oftentimes if you're one of the least, one of the last in earthly terms, what Jesus is saying is you're going to be one of the first in the kingdom of heaven. Humility matters. The way we live our life matters. These are stark realities about our present day that have eternal consequences. When Jesus reminds us the first will be last, he's reminding us again, don't think too much of yourself, that there's a posture of humility that's necessary before the Lord. There's a posture of humility that's necessary if you want to taste heaven. And many who think they're sitting pretty when time comes, when God comes, are going to be on the outside looking in. And Jesus is trying to remind us, look, don't fear God. God is pure love. God is pure mercy. We don't bring these warnings up as Christians, these gospel warnings, to try to instill fear in people. We're not trying to make someone so fearful that they follow God. That's not the point of the gospel. Jesus is reminding us here, don't fear God, but fear sin, because sin is death. Don't think so much of yourself that you're not thinking of God. Don't think so little of sin that you think that sins are no big deal. That is the critical error. That's where the automobile of sin gets us into that HOV lane. And Jesus is trying to remind us again, it's a narrow gate. It's a hard path, but it's not impossible. Not if we're humble. Not if we have the grace of God. Not if we lean on the grace of the sacraments. And not if we trust in God's mercy and live that way. May God bless you this week.
More shows can be seen on Faith and Life Television at faithandlifetv.com.